Brian Powell of I Run Far here with Claire Gallagher before the 2018 Trail World Championships. How are you, Claire?
I'm great. Thanks, Brian.
You've been traveling around a lot this year, haven't you?
Yeah, I have. Not necessarily for running the entire time. Actually, no, it has been, but yeah.
Not
a race in Italy in Cinque Terre.
50K.
Mm-hmm. Very hilly, like.
Yeah.
Like 8,500 feet again for 50K.
That's a solid 50K.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And then, yeah, Ethiopia for running.
What was that also, like?
Crazy. Like, by far the poorest place I've ever been.
Yeah.
I've spent a lot of time in Southeast Asia. And yeah. It was my first time in Africa. And, like, the running culture is so inspiring.
Really?
Yeah.
What's that like?
Like, being in Bokoji, which is, like, where the documentary Town of Runners is based after, this highland village, 9,000 feet above sea level. And it's, like, flat, though. And so these people, like, you know, the runners can just crush fast miles flat. And Ethiopian has a very, like, strong team ethic. So, or Ethiopian distance running. So yeah. Everything's done as a group. Like, drills,
really?
Runs, everything. And, you know, no one has running water. Like, everyone eats, like, maybe 2-3 meals a day of injera.
And
like, this shiro hummus stuff. And they're just, like, the fittest people on earth. And they farm when they're not running or in school. So it's like, yeah, you wonder why you're so fit. But then the rest of Ethiopia that doesn't have that, like, luxury. I mean, those people are, like, subsistence agriculture living. You know, don't have, like, any wiggle room to, like, run for recreation.
So
it's pretty mind-boggling, yeah.
Like, on both levels. But
yeah,
okay, the absolute poverty. And then seeing these people train at a very high, I mean, the highest level.
Yeah.
On slightly more than nothing.
Right. Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Was that inspiring to see, like?
For sure. It definitely made me, like, realize how soft I am once again.
Like, you think you're doing all right. Yeah, and then
you're like, wait, okay. Yeah. And it's, if anything, it was more inspiring to think about climate change in a new way. Like, how people are so, so vulnerable to climate change in, you know, like, northern Ethiopia, where they're drought prone.
Is that what brought you there, or?
It was actually with this organization, Girls Gotta Run, which is a really sweet org, that funds girls to stay in school and run. Otherwise, you get married as, like, a 14-year-old, like, very standard, and you have a kid by your 15 years old, so.
Wow.
Yeah.
And now here you are.
And now we're in Valencia.
Valencia on the coast.
I feel like we're in The Stranger a little bit. Have you walked on the boardwalk yet? You know, it feels like, I mean, I think that took place in Algeria, The Stranger.
I haven't
seen
it, no.
It's like a book, Albert Camus.
Okay.
And it's like a
little different.
Yeah.
I've only been on the boardwalk at, like, 2 a.m. running with Megan. So.
Okay. Yeah, fair.
It was fairly deserted then. So you've been traveling around a lot.
Mm-hmm.
Have you been able to train through that, or?
Yeah. Well, okay. It's May. It's super early. I, like, didn't ski a lot this winter because I just didn't want to, like, do competitive ski-mo. And
yep.
Not to say I haven't been running. Like, I feel relatively ready, but, like, I'm definitely not overtrained.
Yeah.
You
were not cooked.
100% undertrained. Little, like, you know, little. I just know I'll be a little bit better at the end of the summer, but we're here and, like, yeah.
You got the first 70K to train for the last 15, right?
Yeah, yeah, exactly. Yeah. It's definitely going to be one of those.
Yeah?
Yeah.
And how are you?
I'm psyched. I'm ready. Like, I think the hotter, the better. I want it to be the worst conditions possible.
Yeah.
It's like a Ryan Smith statement. You know? Like, Scottish Ryan Smith. He's like, it better be the worst thing ever, because then we have a chance. It's all about bad conditions. No, but I feel good. The uphill, net uphill benefits my strength. So,
yeah.
Like, that I feel actually really psyched about.
Have you been able to see any of the course?
No.
Never? No.
Nope.
No, so run. I don't think any of the U.S. runners have.
Yeah, Zach Miller did. So he's.
Well, I mean, like, in the past couple of days.
Oh, yeah.
Yes,
yeah.
But not.
Not previously. Timmy Olsen, well, he's not racing for the U.S., but I actually haven't even asked him what he thinks about it. But that's. I'm excited to see it on Saturday.
It'll be an interesting challenge.
Yeah.
Yeah. So there's obviously the individual aspect of this race. Are you looking forward to sort of getting back into a team aspect?
Oh, yeah. It's so fun. Like, so I get to here. I've never met. I'm rooming with Amy and Danny and never met them before. And we're like, well, it's just like cross country all over again. You know, we're like six people on a team and we have two rooms for us girls. And so we're just like, it's like fun team bonding. We're like washing sand off in each other's feet in the shower from the beach. Yeah, it's great.
And it seems like there's some good energy there. I saw you guys or gals walk into the lobby and Danny has some spirit, it seems.
Oh yeah, Danny's hilarious. She's, I think, like a total underdog dark horse because of her speed on the road.
She has a lot of speed. I mean, that's unquestioned. Like, can you give us any, fill us in at all about, she talked about her trail running experience?
She's hilarious. And she's like, wait, so how do you call, what is your Western? Like kind of asking some super endearing, just getting into the trail scene. Clear she's getting.
So there's a lot of wild card.
Yeah, exactly. And she's been doing a lot more hills than she's ever run before. I mean, she used to be running like 120 mile weeks on the roads, which is crazy. So I think she's going to be way strong, even though she's really self-deprecating and like thinks that, you know, she's new to trails.
Now, is there a way, this being a team race, is there a way to like say, you know, have Danny run with you or, you know, like don't go out too hard because it's going to be tempting for somebody.
Totally, totally. I think we'll probably talk about it a little more. On Friday, like specifics. It's so hard to tell though because like I don't know, even though I feel like I'm not at my peak fitness, I don't know where that is in relation to like our teammates, which is fun. But I don't know if we have like a captain or anything, but I think we'll have a little round table just to get everyone's nice. I guess I'll lead it to get everyone's like sort of plan because I think we have a shot. I think we're deeper than some may think.
There's some depth there. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. So I mean, we're not Spain or France, but
they do have a really great teams.
Yeah. Yeah.
And I mean, there's a big difference there. I mean, it's hard to come over from the U.S. travel. Intercontinentally and
perform,
there's a cost involved and all of that,
like,
there's a lot of support from those Spanish and French federations.
I'm still like trying to learn like where trail running fits in like USATF and I find it so confusing and like the fact that like I should know this, right? This is like kind of my job and So the U.S. like, you know, there's a lot of U.S. runners who turned down this team to run in Transvolcania, which is something that should be noticed by our people.
Well, I mean, Hayden Hawks is here.
Yeah.
And he's going to run the UTWT.
Yeah.
I'm sure he gets support for that.
Like, right. So. Right. Exactly. Yeah.
So it's understandable why.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Right. And support, we mean like paying for flights and stuff.
Yeah. No, I mean, it's nothing. Yeah. It's not a critique of the actual team leaders here at all.
Right.
It's
exactly. Like, it's just like a bureaucratic.
It'd be an interesting, you know, how do the U.S. athletes or the U.S. fans or everybody influence sort of getting that support to make it more attractive and make it, you know, easier for people who want to be a team member and
totally
come race.
Because the team element's super fun. Like this will be a really fun race to spectate. Like, are you excited? Do you like watching?
Yeah. Team? I grew up running in high school and college and the most fun of anything was cross country because of that team aspect.
Yeah.
And I mean, to be able to be an adult and get back into that. I mean, if you're in a big city, there's cross country meets and that kind of stuff, but most people don't have that in any meaningful way.
Mm-hmm.
And,
unless you're part of a hash hound harrier, you know, like,
not in a competitive sense. Like, totally. So having that, both as a runner is super awesome and to watch it. I remember being at the finish line 2 years ago in Portugal. Yeah, it was the Portugal race. And like adding up the times, like on the back of a notepad of like the French women and the Spanish women. Like
that's so fun.
Or like going home that night and like they didn't, one of the races in the past couple of years didn't post the cumulative time for all the teams, and I was adding up like the men's scores.
Oh my gosh!
Like,
so you didn't know.
No. Like, yeah. And you knew, like, in that case, like, who was first, second, like the first and second place teams were.
Okay.
I mean, it was clearly either the French or the Spanish in the other one.
Okay.
But then the third place team, I'm like adding up the minutes and figuring it all out, and like, so having that team aspect definitely makes it interesting. And seeing a Spanish team go out really hard, and then a couple guys drop, and the French team or whatever, like, it's fun.
Yeah. Totally.
So, folks who are thinking about it in the U.S., come on out after the team.
Yeah, like, yeah. And, like, I don't – yeah. Is it ATRA or is it USATF?
It's USATF.
It's USATF.
Selection, yeah.
Yeah, okay.
So,
interesting,
Now you know.
Right. Yeah. Notes, things to – no, I'm just kidding. Things to do.
Well – sounds like you're ready to go have some fun out there, Claire. And
yeah, it'll be great. We're going to have lots of fun. You guys better yell hard.
We will be yelling and cheering and
Are you using some Spaniards or like to help with coverage?
No.
Some locals, really?
Oh, we have our Argentinian friend, Mauri.
Oh, nice. Okay.
Pagliacci will be here helping us. And otherwise, it's Megan and myself and Mauri's three teams out on the course. And go team.
I run far.
So there's a pre-race bonus question for you. Did you travel with any kitchen appliances?
Oh my god, I did. This is a shout out to Dylan Bowman, who told me he never travels without a rice cooker, and I thought I should travel with a rice cooker. So I got a personal size little rice steamer.
So it's you and Amy and Danny and your rice cooker.
Exactly. Yeah.
Now you know.
And Valencia is like home of like this rice in Spain.
You got some paella here.
Yeah. So we can do like hotel room.
Awesome.
Debo.